Good morning, students. Today we are going to revise our lesson, The Decline of the Mughal Empire. Okay, so in the decline of the Mughal Empire, first of all, the period of change happened. What was this change? The transition from medieval to modern period, which began with the decline of the Mughal Empire. As the Mughal Empire declined, the modern period started. Now, in the decline of the Mughal Empire in the first half of 18th century, this was followed by the English East India Company, territorial conquest and the beginning of political domination of India in the middle 18th century had helped in the started of the modern period. That means the coming of Britishers in India had started the modern period. The modern period in India is generally regarded as having begun in the mid 18th century. Now, during the first half of the 18th century, what happened? In that time, the great Mughal Empire decayed and disintegrated. So, the Mughal emperor lost their power and glory. During this time, the full empire shrank into few square miles. The unity, stability of the empire was fully disturbed, and there were always rivals among the nobles who used to administer the empire. The death of Aurangzeb, the last of the great Mughals, was followed by the war of succession among his three sons. Bahadur Shah eventually ascended the throne in 1707 at the age of 65. Now, he became the first in a line of emperors referred to as the later Mughals. So, Bahadur Shah was referred to as the in the line of the later Mughals. Next, there were certain reasons for the decline of the Mughal Empire. Today, we are revising the lesson. In the next class, we'll start with the next lesson. Okay? And today, you are going to practice the revision work on this lesson in the worksheet section. So the reasons for decline of Mughal Empire were the politics in the Mughal Empire. First, there were four groups of nobles in the Mughal court: Iranis, Turanis, Afghans and Hindustanis. The Iranis, underline it, short questions can come from here. Iranis hailed from Persia, Turanis from Transoxiana, and the Afghans came from mountainous border regions across the river Indus. Now, the Mughal court was a house sharply divided from within. So, this resulted in the constant struggle for power among these groups. Their mutual jealousies and rivalries caused great harm to the Mughal administration and undermined the prestige and authority of the Mughal emperor. Then came the Jagirdari crisis. In addition to the competition for political power and influence, there was a scramble for the best and the most profitable jagirs among the rival nobles. The Mughal officers were given jagirs as payment for their services. Towards the end of 17th century, there were very few jagirs left to satisfy the demands of the newly recruited officers. Crown lands were converted to the jagir lands and given to the nobles. This led to a loss of revenue for the royal treasury and a further decline for the power and empowerment. Then came the weak military organization was one of the reasons for decline of Mughal Empire. As to maintain the absolute power, Akbar used to reorganize his army system under the Mansabdari system. This system worked very well under Akbar, but after him it started to decline. Later, an increase in number of mansabs also and shortage of jagirs came up. The mansabdars did not maintain their quota of troops and adopted corrupt methods. This led to a decline of the military system. Even the Mughal army also failed to keep pace together with the modern times. So the modern rulers did not have the navy support. They did not have a strong navy or good military system with modern equipment. Hence, it was far behind from the Britishers. It was far behind from the Britishers. So nothing was done to reform, modernize and strengthen the army. Next. War of Succession. The death of Mughal ruler was generally followed by the wars of succession among the rival claimants to the throne. These civil wars proved very costly and destructive also. They drained the resources of the empire, caused frequent political upheavals, and made the empire unstable and weak. Aurangzeb's policy. Aurangzeb was not very successful as an emperor. He failed to realize that the progress and stability of such a vast empire depend on a policy of religious tolerance and the support and unity of the people. His policy of religious tolerance shook the foundations of the empire and resulted in the following. What was that? The costly, long-drawn and ruinous Deccan campaign. Numerous wars with Sikh people happened. Yes, because he did not respect the other community people and did not get the support. Loss of support of royal Rajputs also he got. So, economic bankruptcy was faced by him. A major cause of disintegration of the Mughal Empire was its economic bankruptcy and the enormous sums of money spent by Shah Jahan on magnificent monuments like Taj Mahal had drained the royal treasury. Aurangzeb's Deccan campaign was a financial disaster that ruined the empire and made it collapse inevitable. Now, in this situation, foreign invasions came. The invasions of Nadir Shah, the ruler of Persia, and Ahmad Shah Abdali, the ruler of Afghanistan, shattered the power and prestige of the Mughal Empire. Nadir Shah looted and plundered Delhi and carried away valuable treasures, including the priceless Kohinoor diamond and peacock throne. Similarly, there were weak successors who, after Aurangzeb, were not able to rule the empire properly. Then there were very inefficient administration system. All the hopes and revival of Mughal Empire had ended. When British decided to challenge the authority of Mughals, they took all the full advantage of its weakness and began to pursue their own plan of establishing. Thus, at the end, Bahadur Shah Zafar, the last Mughal, assumed the leadership of the rebels in the revolt of 1857 against the British. He was defeated and exiled to Rangoon, where he died. And the Mughal Empire came to an glorious end. Now, Mughal Empire had lasted for over 3 centuries. Just imagine, students. It declined in the first half of the 18th century and led to intense rivalry among the various ambitious powers to fill the political vacuum. The struggle ended with the victory of the British, and thus who would rule India for nearly 200 years. This marked the beginning of the modern period in the Indian history. So this is the revision of the lesson. I have given you the worksheet also to practice and answer those we are going to discuss in the live class about it. Okay, if any doubt is there. Thank you, students. And next class we are going to start the new lesson. As this lesson revision work is completed today, we are going to start the new lesson.